Today we are going to do the physics topic. That is a neat topic. One particular sum, that is kinetic theory of gases, heat and thermodynamics. That is the title. In particular, kinetic theory of gases. This particular topic appears in both physics as well as chemistry. Right, that is a big advantage. You know, as a placement, as a part of career guidance and placement initiative, from the encouragement of our principal, H.S. Balakrishna, and the chairman, Dr. Govind, it's only for economically and academically weak sections we are doing this. That is for NEET, AME, and even IIT. IIT already, we are getting lot of encouragement, especially some people that want to do for that CET exams also. Karnataka CET exams, that also included, and we are getting enquiries across the states, different state, especially this for NEET coaching for Tamil Nadu, Andhra, and even Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, and all that. And this particular question, it has come in from Uttar Pradesh. A student has written and sent through WhatsApp. I have rewritten. And see here, you must know the background of this particular problem. First you read the temperature at which the root mean square velocity. See, that means what? RMS, root mean square velocity of a gaseous of hydrogen molecule. Gaseous hydrogen molecule is equal to that of oxygen molecule at 47 degree. That means root mean square velocity. You must know the formula of root mean square velocity. How to start with? That means, you know the formula, PV is equal to 1/3 MNC square. This is the basic formula everybody remember. Where pressure and volume, M is mass of an atom, n is number of atom, and m into n is equal to m, this is what, molecular weight, right? Sometime atomic weight also, if you write, m may be atomic weight if it is a argon or single molecule atom, or it will appear for everything, killer molecular weight. Here hydrogen, they said hydrogen is a diatomic molecule. You have to remember atomic weight of hydrogen is 1, atomic is 1, atomic weight of oxygen is what, 6 and 8, right? Okay, this what, Z is what, number of proton, this is number of proton plus neutron, and hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, halogens, all are diatomic molecules, you know this, that is chloride, bromide, iodide, even fluoride, all are diatomic molecules. Ozone is, it contains three atoms, oxygen is 2, hydrogen is also 2. Now here, root mean square velocity you have to calculate. What is C? C is called root mean square velocity. Now first you find out the expression for root mean square velocity. That is PV is equal to 1/3 MC square. You know PV is equal to RT for 1 mole of a gas. You know, for 1 mole of a gas. Wherever PV I am writing, RT, 1/3 MC square. Now we want to find the velocity, right? Therefore cross multiply, MC square is equal to 3RT. RC square is equal to 3RT by M. RC is equal to square root of 3RT by M. This is the formula everybody remember. Most. If you can't remember, you have to write this slowly and do it. And before the exams, if you practice several times, this will come. sometimes you may not remember this 3 and R remembrance. See, the C here, R is not universal gas constant at a given temperature. At a given temperature, that means temperature is constant. C is what? Inversely proportional to square root of molecular weight. See, this ideology is important. How you are getting it? See, the idea. That means this is constant at a given temperature. Therefore, how to write? C is inversely proportional to square root of molecular weight when temperature is kept constant. Or sometime you can write here also at constant temperature. Okay. Next, coming to this one, read the problem again. What temperature, the temperature at which the root mean square velocity of hydrogen, because gaseous hydrogen they give, liquid hydrogen is also there, right? That is a gaseous hydrogen molecule equal to that of molecule at 47 degree. What does it mean here? English is the problem. That means it says velocity depends on temperature. But higher temperature, velocity will be more. Right? Suppose when the temperature decreases, what velocity also decreases? It freezes. At one particular velocity, said velocity of oxygen molecule at 47 degree. Right? And velocity of hydrogen molecule at some temperature they are asking. Right? At what temperature the velocity of hydrogen is equal to velocity of oxygen at 47 degree. 47 degree they are given. Okay. Now this is in Kelvin. Therefore, now how to start with? Next, M is there. What is the problem of molecular weight of hydrogen? It's called 2 because 1 into 2 molecules, 2. Then molecular weight of oxygen is equal to 8. Right? Diatomic molecules, what? Sorry, 8 and 16. See, 16. Oxygen is contain 8 proton and 8 neutron, 16. Therefore, molecular weight of oxygen is what? 32. Because 16 into 2 is 32. Let me see, 32 times bigger, hydrogen is so small, right? Okay, which will be faster? That means, hydrogen is faster, is it not? Okay? Suppose at a given temperature at 47 degree, this is so big, this is so small, therefore this slowly, it moves at certain velocity. Okay? But same, it will not move at the same, it will be going at a high velocity. Therefore what happens, at 47 degree so much, right? What is 47 degree? 47 degree, you know how to convert it to Kelvin. 273 plus 47, right? You can change like this, is it not? How much? T is what? 320 Kelvin. Okay? 320 Kelvin. Now, what I do is, here you find the relation between these two. Right? Temperature also, see, I am going to make this type of things. C is directly proportional to temperature and inversely proportional to molecular weight. Temperature is the higher velocity. Velocity is directly proportional to square root of temperature. Therefore, C of hydrogen, the C of oxygen is equal to, they are related, directly related now. I am going to put like this. T of hydrogen, T of oxygen into inversely related, this is inversely, therefore molecular weight of oxygen by molecular weight of hydrogen. Okay, they are equal, is it not? They are equal. Or you can do like this, square root of temperature of hydrogen and molecular weight of hydrogen is equal to, because velocities are equal, isn't it? That is velocity of, see, velocity of carbon oxygen is equal to velocity of hydrogen, or velocity of hydrogen is equal to velocity of oxygen at that some temperature. Some temperature, velocity of hydrogen at that temperature is equal to velocity of oxygen at 320 degree, 320 Kelvin. Therefore, what I write? Square root of T of hydrogen divided by what else? Molecular weight of hydrogen is equal to square root of T of oxygen divided by molecular weight of oxygen. Square root get cancelled. This is how much? Hydrogen is what? 2. Oxygen is what? 16. Right? Hydrogen is 2 or 16. Therefore, what I do is T of hydrogen divided by this is 2. This is equal to T of oxygen how much? 320 divided by this is 16. How many times? 2 times, is it not? Therefore, T of hydrogen is equal to 40 Kelvin. Now, in this answer, which is the correct? Sorry, I did a mistake here. Not 16, this is 32. 32. Therefore, what will happen? This is 1 time, this 2 times 16. 16, 20 times. Therefore, T is equal to what? 20 Kelvin. The correct answer is this. See, I encounter a lot of distraction while doing this, as well as recording it. Because as I was doing a lot of problems, there was an external distractions was there. I am overcoming and doing it. Therefore, but in the exam hall, I don't think so you get the type of distractions. Okay, that is the reason. You can solve in 2 minutes. Therefore, here, in the examination, how fast you have to do it? See, most of the students, they remember C is equal to 3RT by M. This formula they remember. And R is constant, this is constant. Therefore, C of hydrogen is equal to C of oxygen at what? 47. 47 means at 320 Kelvin. So fast you have to calculate. 273 plus 47, how much? 320. Therefore, what you write? Square root. Both are equal. Now, square root is automatically get cancelled. The T of hydrogen by molecular weight of hydrogen is how much? 2. But T of oxygen is what? 320 by molecular weight of oxygen is 32. 16. Or directly you can do this. This is 10. Cross multiply TH2 is equal to 20 Kelvin. You can do this sum in half minute or 1 minute. 1 minute. But slow, I took so slowly all that. I made you to remember all this. Right? Therefore, if you get this type of sums, see, I'm going to collect and do on 10 to 20 sums on the same basis. Right? This is the starting point. What you have to do, you have to go and refer the textbook, collect all these type of sums, old question paper, you go through that, and your tuition notes, and your college notes, your friends notes, everything you collected, you do on this about 10 to 20 sums, it will be easy. Right? Okay? Thank you. I will start the next problem in the next video. Thank you.